pose yourself like an object of pity? Why do you act as if your situation is the worst? Like there is no other person who has such situation. Yours is worse. Like it's worse. Why? Why not pick up yourself? Put yourself together. Get a skill. Add it to your job. And live your life the way it should be. There is no one who is actually comfortable. Not even the richest man on this planet Earth. The richest man needs some more. Just like the popular book we read, Oliver Twist. Oliver Twist wants some more. There is no one that can say, I am okay. Even the people who are actually struggling more are the ones who are wealthy. They want to acquire more wealth because they have more responsibility. So why do you think your case is different? Your case is not different. You can make it. I want to give you an instance. I want to give you a living example of a case that poses to be impossible, a case that poses to be a pitiable one, like hopeless one. Yet, it will shock you to know that the person in this state, the person who is experiencing this situation of hopelessness actually has hope, even more than you. And this man is the popular man we have seen on the social media platform. You can Google it. The man's name is Paul Richard Alexander. This man caught polio when he was 6 years old. Till date, the man should be in his 78 years, because the last time I checked, he was 77. And now he should be in his 78 years, still surviving and still earning. This man is a professor. He got a scholarship. He went to school. He's a lecturer. Like, you ask yourself, how possible? The picture is already on the screen. That man that you're watching right now, the man that you're seeing lying, fixed with different machine, that is the man I'm talking about. He does a lot. Why stuck in there? He earns daily pay, monthly pay. He motivates people. He lectures people. He's not just really like, my own paralysis, my own polio is not the one I can manage on a wheelchair. He's not even sitting. He's always lying the way you're seeing it in the picture. So is your case more difficult, more hopeless than the case you're seeing on the screen? And because of our case, this man is now popular. You see, it is very important to get popular. Let people know you with something good, something impossible. You made it possible. Not getting popular in a criminal way. The only way we can hear you or hear your name is when you have done something wrong. Can you get popular even in your poor state? Your struggles will make you popular. The adventures, the steps you take might just make you popular, might just make you an inspiration to others, might just make you a mentor. So do not think that you have to be wealthy before you can become popular, or you have to be wealthy before you can be someone else's mentor. In your state, in your unique state, you can be exactly what you want to be. So the ball is in your court. Yes, Esther has spoken. And this Esther is your babe, your one and only babe. Your one and only babe. We are not two, just one. One Esther Shine. Yes, Esther of BSA, aka Esther Shine, of your favorite show, The Boldest TV Show. I welcome you to tonight's program. It's going to be touching. It's going to be challenging. Yes, from our opening, you already have a clue of what we are expecting. And what we are expecting is nothing new. It is nothing strange. It is something you have seen on this show. People who have actually made names, earn a living from the skill they acquired, despite their education. Now on this show, we have a copper that we are going to show you. The copper has once upon a time been on this show, who also recap her interview and hear what she has to say, if it has something to do with your situation right now, as a student, as a copper, or as a graduate who looking for government or waiting on government to give you job. You don't have to do that. You are your own government. I used to tell you, just make sure you empower yourself and God will touch people around to encourage you. You do not sit and pray for empowerment. You take steps and help will come. And all this and more we're going to see after we go on this break. When we come back, we immediately kickstart with the interview of this copper. She was a copper, but as I speak, she's done with her serving Nigeria and she's somewhere earning big money. Join me on this break. When we come back, we kick off from there.
BOLDEST. This is the best TV program where talents are harnessed, youths are encouraged, and in fact, watch the program. I don't want to let the cat out of the bag, okay? Watch it, you'll enjoy it.
Nonsa Diobi, and I'm here to tell you to keep on watching the BOLDEST TV show. The King Says So.
You they run the globe, you can't follow me, go party. You see, this is our mega echo estate.
Continue.
We they enjoy Nepal lights. You see solar energy, 100%.
Jesus!
You see security. Hey, nobody will come for night. You go say, I don't know my neighbor. May they not do this or may they not. Lie. I should just attack. Bam. Security, 100%.
Jesus!
Only water I've been looking for.
You see water? Water not they dry one day.
Hey!
Water they run. Brrrr.
Jesus!
Water, I say, pump water. Light, uncle, it they can't pay.
Jesus!
What you need for this estate? Jiggy-dig-ba. You go there, smile when they come out for your ass. You go there, happy. But let go there, sweet you. You know what I talk about?
Not be juju be that.
Come, let's go.
Now you can't disturb me more. We go out so opening. Now you want to call the chairman.
70 years old man.
Wait, before we start to go, eh? I go give you one number. Manager number.
Continue.
You not go charge you. Just tell her and say you want to see the estate. Now free now. To look now free now. Again, they pay money for look.
Funke!
Where did they pay money for look? Just call her.
Funke!
You go joke around, you go to the estate. Make I give you the number. Now the number be this.
Show the BOLDEST TV show. Now a quick one, let's just see this copper then, like then copper, because as we speak she's no longer a copper. Let's see what she made as a copper then, and then imagine what she's making right now as somebody who has finished serving and she's 100% independent. Please join me on the stream.
What is your name? Hello, I'm Oga Beatrice calling from Delta State, Nigeria. I am Oga Beatrice from First River State. First River State, Northern Side precisely. I am a graduate also. I graduated from First River University of Technology. I read Mass Statistics. That was 2014. But right now, I am serving in Delta State as a form. Thank you, my boy. It's something that I love doing. I have passion for fashion. Even while I was still in the university, like from my second year, I started it, even in my veranda. I have people that are working under me. I was training people. So it's something that I love doing. I feel very happy anytime I see someone wearing my design. Like if it's actually very fit on them, and then from then I get good contacts. So I love to work. I don't think that I even work in an office because I want to make this a very big fashion in the future.
Wonderful.
Yeah. It was in my year 2 second semester in the university. I was living in an area that I have a lot of fashion designers there. And then there was one particular lady that I love so much. Anytime I pass and see her design, I always like it. So I one day I summoned courage. Because I was not having money as a student, then you should know what it takes, you know. I was not having money, I just summoned courage. I met her, I discussed with her, I told her about my view. And before then, I've already learned how to paddle manual machine, not industrial. like, I told her everything, and she said, okay, no problem. Since you really love the job, you want to work with me, I will accept you. I said, thank you, madam. After school, I will come. And she then said, okay, thank you too. Then I waited around for something after my lecture, a lot of stress. I still went there. And then she gave me some clothes. I coupled them very well and came out to her test. At any time, and then she now said I should resume the work that week. That was how I started learning with her. From there, fresh ideas, and then the passion I have for it. I got good things, search online, watch online Pinterest and all that. So from there, I picked up. And then I packed out of the place. That was September of that same 2014. September, I left the area. That's like I registered August, September, I left. Because of the environment, it wasn't suitable for my studies, so I left. Then after then, I went to a new place. So from there, that first experience that I had in a shop, I started practicing it on my own. Then I started buying 1-2 machines, butterflies then in school. At that veranda, that was how I started it all, and then this.
Hello,
can you see me?
Yes, hello? I'm seeing you.
Okay. This is what I'm making. It's a ball dress. Okay. Ladies wear them. Even pregnant ladies, young women. It's more like ready to wear. You can see it is a combination of lace, veil lace, with antara. This place is a stripe like this. Put on your tie them. Hello, are you still there, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm sorry to come on the back. It's the last time. Can you see it very well, ma'am?
Yes.
There's one thing I can always tell people is you just have to determine yourself. You just have to believe in yourself that I can do something with or without anybody. Because even when this whole dream of fashion started in my university days, like I was buying my machine with the little pocket money that I have, I was still using it and buy more machines, and then I have people coming to work under me. It's very simple. All you just need is to stay focused in whatever you believe on. Not necessarily you must start on the road or start admiring some kind of things you know your money cannot afford, but you can just start somewhere and then you get to that level you want in life. And my major advice to them is that every awaiting stage of your life, that you should always learn how to start doing something. Don't waste any moment of your life. Okay, if you are a student about going to school, at least you have some interval of months, within that month you can use it and make out something more stable for yourself. So that with time, you will now enjoy it and you will be self-independent. Better because anytime I design a clothes for someone, I've made bridals for several people, I've made clothes for different people in a different way, even states, like up till now, I'm still getting a lot of orders. People are placing orders every day. I deliver to Lagos, Port Harcourt, Calabar, my city. I deliver to Abuja, some kind of state, Kaduna, even Maiduguri, I've delivered to that extent. And then people keep recommending, because as soon as you see my designs, you will always love to have more of it. And then someone will always want to ask for my number. That's how I'm making my own contacts. It's not just limited to Asaba, it's worldwide. I've been delivering worldwide, and we are consistent, we are reliable, and we are trustworthy, because we keep to time, and every design you ask for, we bring it out. Thank you.
Wow. You have seen it. Yes, so you do not have an excuse. Ah, Mama, I've graduated for over 20 years now. No job. How could you sit and say you graduated over some years ago and up till now you have no job? Correct, you have no job. So you also have no skill? Do I need, or do the government need to come to your doorstep and knock, bong, 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 and say, come, you must learn this skill or we shoot you? No, it has not gotten to that. So if up to now you've not found something doing, it is your fault. Can you just please leave the government alone? The government has given you the constitution that has given you democratic nature. That is how our constitution is. That is to say you have the freedom to do certain things. Now, if getting a skill is part of what you have to do, or have what you have to get yourself, so how is it connected to this same government? That is the question you have to think about. So if you are out there and you are a graduate, or you are yet to get yourself into school, and you're sitting down waiting until you have money to write JAMB and you go to the university, even after writing the JAMB, you might still not have money to start up the school. Then you're wasting your time, because there is no time to waste. So I will advise you, just like our last program where the pastor talked about how you can actually acquire a certain skill even without following or paying much to learn it. Because some of us would say that the money you use for the agreement, or the money you pay to learn a skill, is huge, and you still do not have that money. She gave us some secrets, some ways we can actually use to acquire the skill. Just go close to the person, make friends, socialize, always visit. Are you getting me? So at this point, you're already acquiring a skill. Before you know it, one day you say, yes, I know I've taught you how to fix wires. Can you accompany me? There's a place I'm going to do a job. I need you to be holding something for me while I climb. I mean, and at the end of the day, you say, thank you for coming. Rather than you sitting and weighing yourself, a homie doing an apprentice job after graduating, I keep on saying it on this program, that pride is not necessary. You can only be proud if you really have something in your pocket to boast of. If you do not, so you have no reason. You can imagine a poor man getting proud. Hunger go kill you. All right, so this is my token of advice, or token advice I have for you tonight, and I hope that you follow through these mentors you're opportunity to see. And that is one important of this show. It gives you an opportunity to see what you may not see. Yes, even if you're always on the social media platform, you may not see everything. What you saw in your platform might be different from what I saw. We share ideas and we share things. It's possible you must have seen it, or it doesn't matter. It's also a reminder. So I want to encourage you, in a nutshell, encourage you to please, if you're a graduate, please get a skill while you pray for God to give you a job. Do not sit at home waiting for a white-collar job. And you out there who have, or who has, a white-collar job, please do not rely on your white-collar job. Also help yourself by getting a skill that you will do comfortably in your house. Shop is not really necessary, but if you have such a opportunity, why not? You can get a shop weekends that you don't go to work. You open your shop, or you put somebody there. Weekend, you go there and do the practical work yourself and earn your money. If you do so, the level of bribery and corruption in your workplace will reduce. Why? Because you are not too hungry for that kind of dirty money. You are interested in working in your office. Month end, they pay your salary. And when you get home, you have another means to survive. So bribing me or intimidating me to bribe you won't be necessary. These are the ways to actually curb or reduce some kind of corruptions that we are encountering now, because the level of corruption is really, really high, and it's coming from every corner. But the children, they are corrupt. These are the things they learn from the adults, the bigger ones. So let us caution ourselves, no matter your situation. Esther Shine is telling you this night that your situation is not the worst. So stop pitying yourself and stand up and take the bold step. Yes, your situation is not the worst. Thank you so much, and let us go and then freshen up a little, and when we'll come back, we begin from our entertainment segment. Please go nowhere.
BOLDEST. This is the best TV program where talents are harnessed, youths are encouraged, and in fact, watch the program. I don't want to let the cat out of the bag, okay? Watch it, you'll enjoy it.
Welcome back to our favorite show, the BOLDEST TV show. Right now, we kickstart with our entertainment segment. Of course, during the week, we experienced two people coming together as one. Yes, and it was so fun. It was a good thing. Congratulations to you, Mercy. Yes, you got married on the 9th of September 2023. Congratulations. God bless you and bless your new home in Jesus' name. And for you out there who celebrated your birthday, congratulations to you all. God bless your new age and bless our country, Nigeria. Yes. I want to take you on a very short break where we have a new series coming.
I don't understand. It can't be like say you don't know my husband personally. When all this one takes that?
To know that sometimes you miss our wives. Okay? Secret self is not only set up in the any man ever has. That's a good one, right?
Abomination. For a man, no problem. Because everybody knows that the man is doing it. But for the woman is not only the husband's wife. She's also the community wife.
Daddy, don't get me out of this.
You're asking me what is the problem. You don't know you are the problem. Up till now, you've not put your house in order. And you're asking me what is the problem.
You're just jealous.
Is it because you're not married? Jealous for what?
You love me now.
Tell me that you're so careful I should marry. Instead of me to marry you,
I remain single. Make sure you finish it. Let's go.
Hi, Joy.
It's like Momo is hungry.
Giant bones.
Hey. I started telling you, before with this rain that is falling down, and then the rain will fill everywhere, and then I'll not be able to go home. Before somebody will take over my wife's sweetness.
Thank you.
up is already on the social media platform, and this is the address on Facebook, on YouTube. Then we are also on TV, we are on NTA Asaba and ABS Anambra. We are there. We are going to give you updates on the time and day that it shows there. This is a family series that will interest you. So if you no longer have time to sit and watch TV, just do follow us on the social media handles displayed on the screen. Subscribe, watch, and comment. There is also room for more auditioning. It's a movie series. That is to say, it has no ending. So you can actually call in for your audition, and you might be part of this story, this touching, inspirational family movie series produced by Peace Media. Thank you so much. And also, if you want to sell your goods and services, or you have events that you're doing, please do not hesitate to dial the number on the screen. I will be right there to serve you better. We do cover events, we manage events, and more. We do a lot. So please do not hesitate to patronize us, as we'll be glad to work with you. And on this note, I want to bid you a good night's rest with much advice that I've given. Like the Bible says, those who have ears, let them hear. I love you. Still your babe, Esther Obiesie, aka Esther Shine, of your favorite show, The Boldest TV Show. Love you. Good night.